Welcome to PEEK's chemistry classes. Today I am talking to you about aromatic hydrocarbons. This is the third part of the chapter hydrocarbons. In this chapter, I will discuss to you about preparation of aromatic hydrocarbons, properties of aromatic hydrocarbons, and the directing influence of monosubstituted benzene, and some multiple choice questions also. The last class we discussed about aromatic hydrocarbons, and aromatic hydrocarbons are compounds containing aromatic ring, and here we are dealing with the compounds containing benzene ring. And you know that benzene contains a ring of 6 carbon atoms with alternate carbon-carbon double and single bonds, and the carbon-carbon bond distance, all the carbon-carbon bond distances are equal, and benzene is stable due to resonance. Also, we can explain the stability of benzene due to delocalization of pi electrons. So, benzene is a flat hexagon of 6 carbon atoms. The carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms are lying in one plane. There is a pi electron cloud above the plane and also a pi electron cloud below the plane. Then how we can prepare benzene and other aromatic hydrocarbons? And you studied that when a sodium salt of an acid is treated with the soda lime, it undergo decarboxylation and form hydrocarbons. So, this is sodium salt of benzoic acid, that is sodium benzoate, when treated with the sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide, that is soda lime. So, these reagents remove the carboxyl group and we get the corresponding hydrocarbon. So, sodium benzoate is converted to benzene. So, when we employ this compound, this is actually a derivative of benzoic acid, that is 2,5-dimethyl benzoic acid, sodium salt of 2,5-dimethyl benzoic acid. When this is treated with the soda lime remove the carboxyl group and it is converted to 1,3-dimethyl benzene, that is metaxylene. So, on heating with the soda lime, aromatic carboxylic acid, sodium salt of aromatic carboxylic acid undergo decarboxylation and form corresponding aromatic hydrocarbon. Then this reaction also we discussed in the last class, that is acetylene reacting. When acetylene is passing through a red hot iron tube, it undergo trimerization. Okay, and acetylene is converted to benzene by trimerization. So, when we change acetylene with the propyne, this is propyne, there it trimerizes, and what we are obtaining is 1,2,3,4,5, that is 1,3,5-trimethyl benzene. So, acetylene and the derivatives can be converted to aromatic hydrocarbons by passing through a red hot iron tube. Then the third method is starting from phenol. Phenol can be reduced to benzene by reacting with the zinc, by heating with the zinc. And zinc remove an oxygen from here and it is converted to benzene. So, phenol can be converted to benzene by reaction with the zinc. So, when we employ this compound, this is actually 4-methyl phenol with the zinc. Zinc remove oxygen, what we are getting is toluene. So, same way other alkyl substituted phenols on reaction with the zinc give the corresponding aromatic hydrocarbon. So, these are the methods for preparation of aromatic hydrocarbons. One is decarboxylation of sodium salt of carboxylic acid, aromatic carboxylic acid. Second, by trimerization of acetylene and their derivatives. And third, by the reaction of phenol and other derivatives of phenol with the zinc. Okay, then I told you about the delocalized pi electron cloud in benzene. So, this pi electron cloud attract electrophiles, they are electron deficient reagents. Electrophiles are electron deficient reagent, or they are positively charged reagents. So, the benzene ring attract electrophiles, but also this benzene carbon-carbon double bonds are not ordinary double bonds. They are delocalized pi electrons. So, it normally do not undergo addition reaction. So, most of the reactions of benzene are electrophilic substitution reactions. Hydrogen is replaced by electrophiles. So, first reaction is halogenation. Benzene reacting with the chlorine in presence of ferric chloride or any Lewis acid catalyst and form chlorobenzene. And this reaction is catalyzed by any Lewis acid like ferric chloride, ferric bromide or aluminium chloride. And this is replacing hydrogen in benzene with the chlorine. Chlorine is actually coming as Cl plus. So, this is replacing hydrogen with the Cl plus. So, it is an electrophilic substitution reaction. And the mechanism of halogenation is, first chlorine react with the ferric chloride and forming an electrophile Cl plus and a nucleophile FeCl4 minus. Chlorine molecule is undergoing heterolytic cleavage. And the Cl plus is reacting with the benzene. I told you that benzene is electron rich and it attracts electrophiles. And it forms a carbocation, this is known as sigma complex or a carbene. Irenium ion like this. Actually, this electron is moving to chlorine. As this electron is moving to chlorine, this carbon become electron deficient. So, that make a positive charge here. This positive charge can be delocalized in the ring that stabilizes this irenium ion or carbocation. So, this first step is generation of electrophile by the reagent. Second step is electrophile reacting with the benzene and forming a carbocation. Then the third step is the reaction of the carbocation or iridium ion with a nucleophile FeCl4 minus, nucleophile formed in the first step. So, this H is transferring to here without electrons, this electron moved to the carbon-carbon bond. So, that way we create a double bond here, a pi bond here. Hydrogen combines with FeCl4, H plus, H without electrons combining with this and forming HCl and FeCl3. So, these are the steps of reactions in, these three steps are involved in all the electrophilic substitutions of benzene. Generation of electrophile as the first step, formation of sigma complex as the second step, and the abstraction of proton by the nucleophile as the third step. Then the second reaction is nitration. Nitration means heating the compound with the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. Benzene on heating with the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms nitrobenzene. And this is known as nitration, and this mixture is known as nitrating mixture. So, it forms nitrobenzene. Here also the mechanism involves three steps: generation of electrophile, formation of sigma complex, and abstraction of H plus, as abstraction of proton by nucleophile. See how sulfuric acid and nitric acid react and forming nitronium ion. First, sulfuric acid donate an H plus to nitric acid. This is nitric acid HNO3. It forms a protonated nitric acid. Then that is H2O plus here, and so that is removing a molecule of water from here, and it forms nitronium ion. That is the electrophile that is reacting in nitration. This electrophile then added to, then reacting with benzene. So it forms a sigma complex like this. This is a carbocation, and this is formed by shifting these electrons, these pi electrons to nitro NO2 plus is attracted by the electrons of the benzene ring. So that way we get a carbocation. When this electron is moving here, it creates a positive charge. Okay, this carbocation, the sigma complex, can be stabilized by delocalization of the positive charge by moving this electron to here and like that. Then the last step, the nucleophile formed in the first step, that is HSO4 minus, abstracting hydrogen from here, hydrogen without electrons, H plus, abstracting proton. So this electron moved to here, and that way it complete the benzene ring. So we get nitrobenzene. So here also it involves step 1 and step 2 are generation of electrophile NO2 plus. Then the second step, formation of sigma complex, and third step, the abstraction of proton by the nucleophile HSO4 minus. So that is nitration. In nitration, the electrophile involved is NO2 plus. And in any electrophilic substitution, when electrophile forming a carbocation, that is stabilized like this. This is a positive charge, this is an electron deficient carbon. Here the electrophile is attached, it can be NO2 or Cl. Then this electron moved to here. When this electron is moving to here, this carbon atom is losing electrons, so it creates a positive charge here. Then in the next shifting, this electron, this pi electron moving to here. So this carbon atom is losing electrons, so that creates a positive charge here. So the positive charge is delocalized in the benzene ring, that stabilizes. And you know that as the number of resonating structures increases, stability of the molecule also increases. Then sulfonation. Sulfonation means heating with the sulfuric acid. When benzene is heated with the concentrated sulfuric acid, that is fuming sulfuric acid or oleum, it gives benzene sulfonic acid. Here hydrogen is replaced by sulfonic acid group, that is SO3H. The product is benzene sulfonic acid. This is sulfonation. Okay, next reaction is Friedel-Crafts alkylation. That is when benzene is treated with an alkyl halide. Benzene is reacting with an alkyl halide in presence of catalyst anhydrous aluminium chloride. So there the hydrogen is substituted by the alkyl group. When benzene is reacting with the methyl chloride, we get methyl benzene, that is toluene. Hydrogen is substituted by the CH3 group. And this reaction is known as Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So when instead of methyl chloride, if you use ethyl chloride, that is CH3CH2Cl, then hydrogen is substituted by CH2CH3 group, that is the product is ethyl benzene. Benzene reacting with, when react with ethyl chloride, the product is ethyl benzene. And the mechanism of the reaction is like this. First, the alkyl halide reacting with the aluminium chloride. So this chlorine is going to here as Cl minus. It generates an electrophile CH3 plus and a nucleophile AlCl4 minus. Chlorine with electrons going to, or this molecule is undergoing heterolytic cleavage. Chlorine is going with the electrons. So we get an electrophile. So this is the generation of electrophile, generation of carbocations. Then this carbocation, alkyl carbocation, methyl carbocation reacting with the benzene, and it form a sigma complex like this. Okay, I told you that the sigma complex is stabilized by delocalization of positive charge by moving this pi electrons. Then the sigma complex reacting with the nucleophile AlCl4 minus, it abstract a proton H plus from here. So that way this electron, these electrons of the CH bond is moving to this side and we get toluene. So this is the mechanism of Friedel-Crafts alkylation. First step is generation of electrophile, that is alkyl halide reacting with aluminium chloride and producing carbocation, alkyl carbocations. Then that carbocation reacting with the benzene and forming sigma complex. Sigma complex is stabilized by resonance. Then this sigma complex reacting with the nucleophile, where the proton is abstracted by the nucleophile, giving the product. So this step also, this mechanism involves generation of electrophile, formation of sigma complex, and abstraction of proton by the nucleophile formed from the reagent, formed from the reagent and catalyst. And I told you that when methane reacting with the methyl chloride, the product is toluene. That is, when benzene reacts with the methyl chloride, the product is toluene. When benzene reacts with ethyl chloride, the product is ethyl benzene. But when it is, when it reacts with the normal propyl chloride, that is 1-chloropropyne, the product is not normal propyl benzene. The product is isopropyl benzene, and the compound is like this. And this is 2-phenyl propane. This compound is named as 2-phenyl propane. What we are expecting is phenyl group attached here, that is 1-phenyl propane. So we are expecting normal propyl benzene, but this reaction gives isopropyl benzene, and that is again due to the rearrangement, or rearrangement in the mechanism of the reaction. First, the normal propyl chloride react with aluminium chloride, it forms a carbocation. That is the generation of the electrophile. But this carbocation is a primary carbocation that rearranges to a secondary carbocation. And you know that secondary carbocations are more stable than primary. And this secondary carbocation, that is isopropyl carbocation, is reacting with the benzene. So the product is isopropyl benzene. So when normal propyl chloride react with the benzene in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, the product is isopropyl benzene. That is due to the stabilization or rearrangement of primary carbocation to secondary carbocation. Then the reaction of benzene with the acid chlorides in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride. So when benzene react with alkyl halide, we called the reaction as Friedel Crafts alkylation, and this is Friedel Crafts acylation. Benzene or aromatic hydrocarbons are reacting with acid chloride in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, and this hydrogen is substituted by the CH3CO group, and the product obtained is a ketone, and this ketone is called acetophenone. When benzene react with the benzoyl chloride, that is the chloride of benzoic acid, we get benzene with the CO and again a benzene ring, that is called a benzophenone. So this reaction is Friedel Crafts acylation, and the mechanism is similar to Friedel Crafts alkylation. So first, the acid chloride reacting with aluminium chloride, this chlorine is going to aluminium chloride with its electrons, so we get acetyl carbocation and a nucleophile AlCl4-. And this electrophile then reacting with the benzene, it forms a sigma complex. As usual in electrophilic substitution mechanism, this is stabilized by resonance. Then this sigma complex reacting with the nucleophile, this hydrogen is abstracted by the nucleophile as H plus. Electrons moving to this side, and that way we get the product ketone plus aluminium chloride plus HCl. So Friedel Crafts acylation is a reaction of benzene with acid chloride in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, and here the product is aromatic ketones, and there the electrophile is RCO plus, depending upon the acid it changes. So in aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions, I told you about Friedel Crafts acylation, Friedel Crafts alkylation, nitration, sulfonation and halogenation. Then about, so these are the main reactions of benzene, they are electrophilic substitution reactions. And I told you that the double bonds in benzene are not ordinary double bonds. So benzene does not decolorize bromine water because the bromine addition is not possible there. And also it does not decolorize dilute KMnO4, Bayer's reagent. That is, benzene does not answer the normal test for unsaturation. But if we employ vigorous conditions, then the carbon-carbon double bond can undergo addition reactions. So this is a reaction, addition reaction of benzene. That is, benzene reacting with the hydrogen in presence of nickel at high pressure and or at high temperature, it giving cyclohexane. So here one molecule of hydrogen is adding, here one molecule of another molecule of hydrogen adding, here another molecule of hydrogen adding. So benzene requires three molecules of hydrogen, and the product is cyclohexane. So in the hydrogenation of benzene with the nickel as a catalyst and in presence at high temperature and or at high pressure, benzene is converted to cyclohexane. So here this carbon-carbon double bond adding one molecule of hydrogen, here addition of another molecule of hydrogen, here addition of one more molecule of hydrogen. So three molecules of hydrogen adding to carbon-carbon double bond forming cyclohexane. Reaction is catalyzed by nickel and at high pressure or at high temperature. Then the reaction of benzene with the chlorine. Okay, I told you that benzene reacting with the chlorine in presence of Lewis acid catalyst, then the reaction is substitution. Hydrogen is replaced by halogens. But when benzene react with halogens, chlorine in presence of ultraviolet light, the reaction is addition reaction. So here also the three molecules are adding to the three double bonds, and the product is benzene hexachloride, and this is also known as gamexine or BHC, that is used as an insecticide. Benzene reacting with the addition of chlorine giving benzene hexachloride. So these are the main reactions of aromatic hydrocarbons, electrophilic substitutions and addition reactions. Then suppose we nitrate nitrobenzene again with the concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. The new nitro group enters at the meta position. So the nitro group already there direct the electrophile to the meta position. So that is called a directing influence of monosubstituted benzene. So group already at that position either direct the new electrophile to ortho position and para position. So such groups are called ortho para directing groups. And sometimes the group may direct it to the meta position, then it is called meta directing groups. So the groups are of two types, ortho para directing groups and meta directing group. Then sometimes the group may increases the rate of the reaction, rate of electrophilic substitution reaction, then we call that group is activating the benzene ring. And in some groups decreases the rate of electrophilic substitution reactions, such groups are called said to be deactivating the benzene ring. Actually, if we take benzene and nitrobenzene, benzene undergo nitration faster than nitrobenzene. So that nitro group deactivate the benzene ring. So nitro group is meta directing, at the same time it is a deactivating group. So benzene on nitration gives nitrobenzene, and nitrobenzene if we further nitrate it, it gives meta dinitrobenzene. The nitro group direct the new nitro group to the meta position. And the nitro group, cyano group, aldehydic group, ketonic group, acid group, ester group, sulfonic acid group, all these groups are meta directing. So if you take benzaldehyde, benzene with the aldehydic group and nitrate it, the new nitro group enters at meta position. Same way if you take benzoic acid, benzene with the acid group and nitrate or chlorinate or Friedel-Crafts alkylation or acylation, the new electrophile enters at the meta position. So these are meta directing groups, and also these groups deactivate the benzene ring. That is, again, if we compare the rate of electrophilic substitution of benzene and benzoic acid deactivate the benzene ring, it decreases the electron cloud of benzene ring. So benzoic acid undergo electrophilic substitution at a lower rate than benzene. So all these groups are meta directing, and also they are deactivators. Then why nitro group act as a deactivator, or why nitro group direct the new electrophile to meta position? So if you look at the resonance stabilization of the nitro group, resonating effect of the nitro group we represent like this: N double bond O, then a coordinate bond. This electron is moving to here, when this electron moved to here, so it being O minus and a double bond here. So this carbon atom is losing an electron, so this make a positive charge here. look at that position, nitro group create a positive charge at the ortho position. When this pi electron moving to here, this carbon atom is losing electron, so we get a positive charge here. And so that way of resonance effect create positive charge at ortho position, positive charge at para position, and again positive charge at ortho position. So the new electrophile is positively charged, it prefers to enter at a position of higher electron density. So the new electrophile when enter into nitrobenzene, it prefers to go to the meta position, that is of higher electron density than, that is more negative than ortho and para position. So that is why the nitro group direct the electrophile to new electrophile to meta position. So if you take toluene, that is benzene, there is a CH3 group in toluene, and nitrate it with the concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid. The nitro group enters at the ortho position, and also we get product with the nitro group at the para position. So we are getting a mixture of ortho nitro toluene and para nitro toluene. So the CH3 group direct the nitro group to ortho position and para position. So that alkyl group, CH3 group, is ortho para directing. Then if we compare the rate of with the benzene, toluene react faster than, toluene undergo electrophilic substitution faster than benzene. So CH3 group is an activating group, it increases the rate of electrophilic substitution reactions. Other groups in this category are NS2, or these are ortho para directing activators, that is benzene with NS2, that is aniline. This is secondary amine, that is NHR group, then amide group, then ether group, OCS3 group, then alkyl group, and also phenol, OH group, are ortho para directing. So these groups are ortho para directing and also the activators of benzene ring, activators for electrophilic substitution. So if you take phenol and treat it with the concentrated nitric acid, OH group is ortho para directing. So the nitro group enters at ortho position, para position, and again ortho position. This is 2,2,4,6 trinitrophenol. OH group activate the benzene ring. So when we nitrate phenol with the concentrated nitric acid, we get 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. Nitro group enters at ortho positions, both ortho positions and at para positions. So OH group is ortho para directing, and also it activate the benzene ring. It activate it so that all the ortho and para positions are occupied with the nitro group. It react faster than benzene. So why the OH group is ortho para directing? That can be explained based on the resonance effect of OH group. It has electron donating resonance effect. Just like water, this oxygen possesses two lone pairs. You know, water contains two lone pairs, and this one lone pair is moving to here, and this electron moving to the carbon atom, that make this position negative. Ortho position is negative, the electron density increases. Then this two electrons, negative charge means two electrons, these two electron moving to here, then this pi electron is localized into this carbon. This create a negative charge at para position. Again moving this negative, these two electrons to carbon-carbon bond here, that shift the pi electrons to this carbon. So that make the this ortho position negative. Look at that resonating structures where the ortho position is negative electron rich, para position is again electron rich, and again this ortho position is electron rich. So the electrophile preferably go to ortho and para positions. And also this resonance, electron donating resonance, increases the electron density in benzene ring. So the rate of the reaction is faster than benzene. OH group activate the benzene ring by increasing the electron density. Then about halogens. So I told you about the groups which are meta directing, which are deactivators, and about ortho para directing group which are activators. But halogen is ortho para directing and deactivates the benzene ring. And you know that halogens are, so if we nitrate chlorobenzene with the concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid, the nitro group enters at ortho position and at para position. So what we are getting is ortho chloro nitrobenzene and para chloro nitrobenzene, a mixture of 2 chloro nitrobenzene and 4 chloro nitrobenzene. This is chlorine is ortho para directing, but if we compare the rate is slow than benzene, and that is due to the electron withdrawing inductive effect of chlorine that decreases the electron cloud in benzene that deactivate the ring by decreasing the electron density. But at the same time the resonating effect produces negative charge at ortho and para position, so the electrophile is entering at ortho and para position. So halogens are ortho para directing, but they deactivate the ring. So three types of groups are there. They are ortho para directing activators. They are CH3 group, phenol, aniline, pheno OH group, NS2 group are examples. Then meta directing deactivators, nitro group, aldehyde, acid, ester are examples of that. Then ortho para directing deactivators are there, halogens are examples of ortho para directing deactivators. So I think that it is the time to discuss the questions, multiple choice questions from this portion. So the first question is, what is the product obtained when O-methyl, that is 2-methyl benzoic acid, is heated with soda lime? Choice A is sodium 4-methyl benzoate, B toluene, C 1,4-dimethyl benzene, D 1,3,6-trimethyl benzene, and E benzene. And you know that reaction with the soda lime is decarboxylation, removing the acid group. So this is O-methyl benzoic acid heating with the soda lime. It removes the acid group, so the product obtained is toluene. So answer is B, toluene. Second question, nitration of benzene with the concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid to form nitrobenzene is a electrophilic addition reaction, electrophilic substitution reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, nucleophilic addition reaction, free radical substitution. Nitration is actually replacing hydrogen with the NO2 plus, and the mechanism involves the reaction with NO2 plus, that is electrophile, and there is no addition. The pi bonds are not reacting, it is only replacement of hydrogen. So nitration is electrophilic, substitution reaction. Then the catalyst used for the following reaction is, the reaction is benzene plus chlorine giving chlorobenzene. Choice A, ferric chloride FeCl3, B, aluminum chloride, C, A or B, D, AlCl4- E, NH3. Actually, the catalyst, the role of the catalyst is Lewis acid, and it is taking the Cl minus and forming the electrophile Cl plus. So, we can use either FeCl3 or AlCl3, both serve as catalyst for halogenation. So, answer is C, A or B. And the fourth reaction question, which of the following is not an electrophilic substitution reaction? Choice A is chlorination of benzene forming chlorobenzene. Look at that compound. There is no addition, there is nothing is happening to the carbon-carbon double bond. Only hydrogen is replaced by chlorine. So, that is an electrophilic substitution reaction. Choice B is reaction with nitric acid and sulfuric acid forming nitrobenzene. There also there is no change in the carbon-carbon double bond. What is happening is hydrogen replaced by nitro group. So, that is also substitution. And choice C, that is Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, that is alkyl halide reacting with the benzene and forming toluene. There also there is no change in the carbon-carbon double bond. Hydrogen is replaced by methyl group. Friedel-Crafts alkylation is electrophilic substitution. But the choice D is reaction with the hydrogen. There hydrogen is adding to benzene and forming cyclohexane. So, that is an addition reaction. So, that is not an electrophilic substitution reaction. So, the answer is D. And the last one is sulfonation, that is a reaction with benzene with the sulfuric acid giving sulfonic acid, replacing hydrogen with the sulfonic acid, that is electrophilic substitution. So, answer is D, that is actually addition reaction. Then which of the following group is orthopara directing? A, nitro group, B, aldehyde group, that is nitration of benzaldehyde, think about nitration of benzaldehyde, then acid group, COOH group, D, ester group and E, CH3 group. And among that, you know that nitro group is metadirecting, it is a metadirecting deactivating group. CHO group, aldehyde, if it nitrate benzaldehyde, it gives metanitrobenzaldehyde. So, these are also, this is metadirecting. Acid is also metadirecting. Benzoic acid gives metanitrobenzoic acid. Esters are also metadirecting. So, orthopara directing activator, orthopara directing group is CH3 group. That is toluene on nitration gives orthonitrotoluene and paranitrotoluene. Sixth question, the product of chlorination of benzene in presence of light is A, chlorobenzene, B, paradichlorobenzene, C, gamaxene, D, benzyl chloride, E, chloroform. So, in presence of light, the reaction is addition of chlorine. Addition of chlorine to benzene gives hexachlorocyclohexane, that is gamaxene. This is benzene hexachloride. When the same reaction happens with the chlorine in presence of anhydrous aluminum chloride, it is chlorobenzene. and in presence of light, that is in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, the reaction is electrophilic substitution, and in presence of light, it is addition of chlorine and the product is gamma-xane. Seventh question, the functional group on benzene which act as orthopara directing deactivators in electrophilic substitution is A. nitro group, B. carboxylic acid, C. halogens, D. methyl, E. OH group. And you know that nitro group is meta directing, carboxylic acid is also meta directing, methyl group is orthopara directing activators, and OH group is also orthopara directing activators. But halogens are orthopara directing, but they are deactivators. I told you that it is due to the electron withdrawing inductive effect of halogen. Eighth question, the product of nitration of ethyl benzoate with concentrated nitric acid and sulfuric acid is, the choice A, the ortho nitro product, choice B, meta nitro product, and choice C, para nitro product, choice D, both A and B, and E is nitrobenzene. Okay, actually the ester group is not orthopara directing, it is meta directing, so product is meta nitro ethyl benzoate. Ninth question, the compounds A, B and C in the following sequence of reactions are respectively, that is calcium carbide reacting with water giving A, then A is passed through red hot iron tube giving B, B on treatment with the concentrated sulfuric acid and giving C. Choice A, benzene, nitrobenzene, acetylene, B, ethene, benzene, nitrobenzene, C, ethyne, benzene, nitrobenzene, D, nitrobenzene, acetylene, benzene, E, ethyne, benzene, nitrobenzene. Do you know that when calcium carbide is treated with water, the product formed is acetylene, that is ethyne. Only choice C contains ethyne, so that is the correct answer, and so that is acetylene. When passed through red hot iron tube, it forms benzene. It forms benzene. The benzene on nitration gives nitrobenzene. So the odd A is acetylene, B is benzene and C is nitrobenzene. Correct choice is C. Tenth question, the product formed when benzene is treated with the excess of chlorine in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride in the dark. A, benzene hexachloride, B, hexachlorobenzene, C, chlorobenzene, D, metadichlorobenzene, E, benzyl chloride. So, in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, the reaction occurring is electrophilic substitution, and with excess of chlorine, all the hydrogens are substituted with the chlorine. So, product is hexachlorobenzene. So, answer is B. 11th question, which pair of groups contains only orthopara directing groups, orthopara directors? Choice A, OH and ketone, B, NH and that is amine, secondary amine and cyanide, C, OCS3 and CHO, D, OCS3 and NS2, E, CHO and COCS3. Which pair group contains only orthopara directors? And that is choice A, this is orthopara directing, but this is meta directing. Here cyanide is meta directing and this is orthopara directing. Here OCS3 group is orthopara directing, but aldehyde is meta directing. Choice D, that is OCS3 group and NS2 group, these are orthopara directing. So if you take aniline, benzene with NS2 group is aniline, and chlorinate under electrophilic substitution conditions it gives ortho product and para product. Same way, this is anisole, it is an ether, the OCS3 group is ortho para directing. When we chlorinate, it gives ortho product and para product. So, answer is D. 12th question, which statement about the reaction of benzene with chlorine in the presence of aluminium chloride is incorrect? Choice A, mechanism goes via an intermediate cation. B, aluminium chloride is a catalyst. C, mechanism is electrophilic addition. D, chlorobenzene is formed. Choice E, both B and C. And you know that the reaction of benzene with the chlorine in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride is electrophilic substitution and not electrophilic addition. So, which is incorrect is the mechanism is electrophilic addition. 13th question, which statement about the reaction of benzene with 1-chloropropane in presence of aluminium chloride is incorrect? Aluminium chloride act as a catalyst. Choice B, major product is normal propyl benzene. C, benzene undergoes electrophilic substitution. D, in the presence of aluminium chloride, 1-chloropropane react to give a carbocation. E, both B and C. So, this I told you that the propyl chloride forming a propyl carbocation, normal propyl carbocation that changes to isopropyl carbocation. So, the product is isopropyl benzene and not normal propyl benzene. So, what is incorrect is major product is normal propyl benzene. And 14th question, which of the following is not a Huckel 4N plus 2 aromatic system? Choice A, cyclopentadienyl anion. B, benzene. C, cyclooctatetraene. D, naphthalene. E, cyclopropanyl cation. And you know that benzene, naphthalene, all these are aromatic because this contains 6 pi electron and naphthalene contains 10 pi electron and this is a 2 pi electron system, but cyclooctatetraene, it contains 8 pi electron, so that is not an aromatic system. 15th question, match the substituent to the stated directing influence and activation effect and which set is incorrect? Choice A, chlorine activating orthopara directing, OH activating orthopara directing, methyl activating orthopara directing, nitro deactivating meta directing, OCS3 activating orthopara directing. And you know that halogens are orthopara directing, but they are deactivators. So, this choice A is the correct answer. Chlorine activating is incorrect. Chlorine is moderately deactivating due to electron withdrawing inductive effect. 16th question, how many dibromobenzenes are possible? Choice A, 1, B, 2, C, 3, D, 4, E, 5. And these are the dibromobenzene. It can occupy the position 1 and 2, can occupy the position 1 and 3, it can occupy the position 1 and 4. That is orthodibromobenzene, metadibromobenzene and paradibromobenzene. So, the dibromo possible isomers are 3 for this. So, answer choice is C. So, these are the questions, multiple choice questions from this topic. So, hydrocarbons are the basic chapter on organic portions. So, studying this hydrocarbons will make you an expert in organic chemistry. Wish you all success in your life. Thank you.